Happy Monday, welcome back to our channel. Today I have some brand new units for you guys. There's one that you guys have been asking me to review all of last week, so I have it to review for you guys today. Hopefully I can post it today. If not, then I'll post it tomorrow. But anyway, the first one I'm going to start off with is one of the sensational Dashley units, and this is Dashley unit 17. I have her in the color T2/copper. Guys, you know the Dashley collection wigs, you are familiar with it. No, I've reviewed Dashley units 1 up to now 17, and I've also reviewed, well, this is a Dashley lace unit, sorry. And then there's a Dashley units that's not lace front. I reviewed all of those as well. And like ever so often, they come out with a new one. So yeah, this is a Dashley lace unit 17. So it is a lace front wig. It is it HD? I don't know, guys, but it looks like an HD. I didn't add my lace and spray to it. I just added powder to the part and to the hairline, but like I said, it looked like an HD lace wig because of how like chalky the lace was looking. So that's what I did. I added powder to it. The hairline isn't that pre-plucked or anything, but it's still not crazy dense. It came with baby hairs and stuff like that. You can use it if you want to. It is a center part, and guys, all I had to do was just add powder to the part. It was clear enough straight out the box. So I just added powder to it, and I used some heat just to flatten around the parting space a little bit because it is heat safe from 350 to 400 degrees. Let me just show you the stock card. And by the way, this is another wet and wavy style wig. It's not a human hair wig, it's a synthetic wig. So you cannot straighten this out and wet it again and it will get curly. This is not how it works. It's just giving you a wet and wavy style, meaning it looks like a wet and wavy style, but it's not actually wet and wavy, if you get what I'm saying. So please do not go adding water to this, or not even adding water to it, but don't go straightening it out and trying to curl it back up and saying that it's not wet and wavy, because it's not, okay? It's just a wet and wavy style. And I say this all the time, every time I get a wig like this, because I know some people really do get it confused. So please don't get it confused. It's just a style, okay? And it does have that little crunch to it. Now, I did finger comb it. I didn't want to brush it out or anything because I didn't want it to look, you know, poofy or anything. So all I did was finger comb it, and you do get a little bit of crunch to it. So right now it's like soft and crunchy. Some parts are crunchy, some parts are soft because I finger combed it. So once you finger comb it out, brush it, comb it, whatever, it will get soft. But for like when you just took it out of the box, it will be a little bit more on the crunchier side. So just keep that in mind. But anyway, in terms of tangling and shedding, I told you guys I finger combed it. I didn't really get any snags, but I did get some shedding from it. So keep that in mind. You may get some strands, but it's nothing too excessive, honestly. But guys, I am gonna give this away. I think it's cute and I think you guys might like it. So I'm gonna give this away. If you guys would like to participate in the giveaway, I will put the rules pinned in the comment section down below. So make sure you follow all the rules, participate in the giveaway, and a winner will be announced this upcoming Friday in the giveaway announcement video. That will be up at 6 p.m. Every Friday at 6 p.m. giveaway announcement video, okay? So make sure to stay tuned for that. But let me just get into the cap construction and then I'll end up this review. So you get two combs up front, one at the back, the adjustable straps, and this is a regular cap construction. It fits pretty comfortable. I would say it's about medium in cap size, but it's very comfortable. There's a little bit of extra room in there, but not that much stretch, so keep that in mind. But anyway, guys, this is it. If you have any questions, anything I may have forgotten to mention, check the description box because I do leave information there, so you may see it there. If not, then leave me a question in the comment section down below. I'll be sure to answer you as soon as possible. Once I see it, I'll respond to you as soon as possible. So thanks again for watching. Don't forget to participate in the giveaway, and I'll see you guys in my next review. Bye.